Welcome to the Northwest Passage Project, where students from every major discipline across the University of Illinois at Chicago applied for a once-in-a-lifetime research expedition. 18 undergraduate students, finalists, were chosen to compete, undergoing rigorous academic training, pushing their mind, body, and attention spans to the limit. But ultimately, only three would win a spot aboard a once-in-a-lifetime research expedition. Who will win? Okay, maybe that's a little intense, but it's the reality TV version. The real story starts back in November of 2016, when Miguel, or should I say Dr. Miguel Gonzalez Meller, put out a call for students of any discipline to apply for an Arctic research expedition, and he selected a core group of 18 undergraduate students to join the project and be trained in a list of core skills needed for the expedition. From microbiology, climate science, to science communication, the team spent the following 6 months preparing to board the SS Oliver Hazard Perry. At the end of the training period, three students were selected to go on the expedition. A fourth alternate was chosen to stand by, and a fifth was scheduled to be sent to the Inner Space Center in Rhode Island to assist with broadcasting and media. And if it's not obvious, that person was me. All the other students were given assignments on other projects of their choice, but none of us could have expected what came next. The phone rang, Miguel sighed, and the expedition was canceled. The SS Oliver Hazard Perry had a mechanical issue and wouldn't be able to handle the extreme Arctic conditions, and we couldn't find another ship to replace her. Everything we had trained so hard for was all for nothing. I'm just kidding. It was just postponed till the next year. Sadly, two of the three original selected finalists graduated and were no longer eligible for the expedition. But that opened new opportunities for others to step up and be a part of something just as great. The next summer, the new finalists sported the Russian research vessel, the Academic Eoth, excited to finally embark on the expedition they had trained so hard for over the past 2 years. And at the same time, I flew to the Inner Space Center in Rhode Island to help with the broadcasts. The ships departed from its rural Canadian port, but unbeknownst to any of us, the expedition would end in disaster. I will never forget. I was in the control room in the Inner Space Center, preparing for our first broadcast with the rest of the communications team, when the live feed from the vessel suddenly went black. We huddled around troubleshooting what could have went wrong when the head of the expedition came in, closed the door, and uttered those fateful words. "What I'm about to tell you," she said, "does not leave this room. We've lost contact with the Academic Eoth, and we don't know if it's still afloat." That moment, the room went silent as our stomachs simultaneously all dropped. The control center was in a buzz, trying to figure out what to do next. What information do we make public? Do we cancel the broadcasts? Are our friends okay? About an hour later, one of the editor's phones rang in the background of this buzzing control center. He yelled out, "It's the Academic Eoth. They're okay." It turned out that the ship had run aground.
"That we never, ever, ever, at any point in time, for legal reasons, thought was sinking."
And while everyone was safe, they couldn't continue the expedition. Meanwhile, the team on board the ship felt a range of emotions, from crying to singing to trying to enjoy the now limited amount of time they had left in the Arctic, completely unsure if they would ever get the opportunity to return. Back at the Inner Space Center, a sigh of relief rang out from the control room, now knowing our team was safe, but the future of the project was still on our minds as well. Would it be two strikes and we're out, or would we get a third opportunity to complete the mission we had trained so hard for? Months later, our funding was extended, and we would have one last shot to achieve our mission. Fast forward one more year. More of us, myself included, graduated, and other members filled our roles. The team again flew to the Canadian Arctic and boarded yet another research vessel called the Icebreaker Odin, but this time they succeeded. They traveled to the Arctic archipelago, capturing data, experiencing the culture, and broadcasting their findings live across the world. Our team had faced all odds, from training, funding bureaucracy, a sinking ship, oh yeah, and the blisteringly cold, treacherous Northwest Passage. But we had done it, and no matter if you were a student on board or one of the many others who had come before and worked so hard to accomplish the expedition, we all felt the same joy and celebration that our hard work had made such an impact. That said, the work was still not over. Throughout the months following the expedition, the team combed through and analyzed the samples and data collected, cataloging their findings for future generations of researchers to reference for their own projects. Other members went to work breaking down the findings to present to audiences across the world, and we even made a documentary. But then in March of 2020, when our first film premiere event and talk were scheduled to take place live on campus at UIC, one of our researchers was running a final test on a sample of Arctic permafrost when the vial fell and broke, releasing a previously extinct strain of COVID-19, causing a global pandemic of zombie Karens who broke into Costco and stole all the toilet paper. Now, okay, I'm obviously kidding about that last part, but it's still so fitting for this project that our film premiere would be canceled by a global pandemic. But a year later, we UIC students and alumni are back. We adapted and are ready to get our message out. Not to get too mushy-gushy, but this expedition teaches us a lot. That number one, a person like Dr. Miquel Gonzalez Meller can see potential and inspire the next generation of STEM professionals, changing the lives of his students and those they reach just because he believed in them. We learned that when a ragtag team of UIC students from the most random mix of professional disciplines come together, a lack of funding, mechanical issues, a run-aground ship, or a global pandemic cannot stop us. And more personally, I learned that science isn't just some incomprehensibly difficult field that only Einsteins can make a difference in, but that even I, a dyslexic kid with a speech impediment, can not only understand, but make a global difference. If you get the opportunity, go watch the film they made about our final expedition called Frozen Obsession, so you can learn from the students turned climate scientists. But either way, I encourage you to take a step back and ask yourself, how can I use STEM to change the world? Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed learning about my team and the Northwest Passage Project. If you did, give this video a like and subscribe with push notifications on. Click here to see a video YouTube suggested just for you and here to see my latest video. Stay you, stay beautiful, and keep smiling. Bye-bye, guys!